So in this video, we are going to apply the upgrades to our towers. And to do that, we will have to go to the Unity editor and open up the upgrade panel and select the upgrade. And as you can see, we have this onclick function here that isn't bound to anything right now, but we will have to bind that to a function that will actually upgrade our towers. So first of all, we need to create that function, and I'm simply going to name it upgrade tower. And I'm going to create it inside the game manager. So inside this function, we have to say if our selected tower isn't null, so we make sure that we have a tower. And if our selected tower.level is less or equal to the selected tower.upgrades and the length of the upgrades, well, then we should be able to upgrade the tower. So basically we're making a statement here that makes sure that we can only upgrade a tower that is upgradable as long as it has a lower level than the max level, basically. So besides this, we also have to make another check. We have to check if our currency is less, or sorry, more or equal to the selected tower.nextupgrade.price. So basically we need to check if we have enough money to buy this upgrade. So then we take the selected tower.upgrades upgrade, and basically this is a function that should upgrade the tower, but we don't have it right now. So we need to go to the tower script and we need to create a new function for upgrading the actual tower here. So let's go to the under the shoot function and create a new upgrade called public, or new function, sorry, called public virtual void upgrade. And what is it supposed to do? Well, we make it virtual so that we can actually override it in the other function or the other scripts, so that our fire tower can override this and make its upgrades for the tick time and everything, so that each tower knows how to upgrade itself. So then we take the game manager instance that currency and we reduce the currency. So basically this is the line of code that we use to buy the actual tower or take the money from the player. And then we simply take the price and add the price to the tower for the next upgrade plus the cost of that, so that when we sell the tower again, we know how expensive the tower is so that we can get half of the money back. And then we take the damage and set it equal to the upgrade's damage. So basically we need to increase the damage, right? We set the proc chance and add it to the next upgrade, the proc chance. And basically, actually the damage needs to be plus equal instead of just equals, because we need to add it to the damage instead of just setting the damage equal to it. If we just set it equal to it, then it will have a damage of one, for example, if the upgrade gets one damage, and that's not what we're interested in. And we also need to set the debuff duration, and then we in the end we set the level, or add one to the level, so that we know what the next upgrade is later. And then we take the game manager's update, so we take the game manager's upgrade tooltip, so that we can see that the tooltip upgrades, and it should reflect the new upgrade we just created, so that we can see what the next upgrade is going to be. If we jump back into Unity, and we select the upgrade, you'll see that we need to set the actual function here. Right now the list is empty. So we select the upgrade and we click the little plus, and here we take the game manager and add it to the onclick function, so that we can select function and go to game manager and find the upgrade function we just created. So when we have done that, we can go back to the script and save, and make sure that all the upgrade function is saved. And if we play it now, and we place a tower, and mouse over it, you'll see that we can see the upgrades, but nothing happens when we click the button. And that's because I haven't executed the function yet. Because if you see, we reduced the currency and everything, but we forgot to actually call the function for upgrading the tower. Right now I'm just setting the currency to 50 so that we have enough money for upgrading it, but as you can see, even though we have enough money for upgrading it, it still doesn't work, and that's because we haven't executed that new function we just created. So let's go to the script and do that. So if we go to the game manager script and go to the upgrade tower function, you'll see that we forgot to call that thing. So we have to say select the tower.upgrade and call that function. And if we save it now and go back to Unity, we should be able to upgrade our tower. So let's give it a try. And upgrade. And as you can see, we upgrade our tower every time we click here. And there we go. So now we just bought all upgrades. And you can see the proc chance is 104%. That's not ideal. So we should fix it so that we don't have that high proc chance. So if we go to proc prefabs and select the towers and range, we can set the proc chance down to maybe 10% on all of them so that it actually fits better with some actual gameplay. Let's just put 10% on each and every one of them. And there we go. So now we have some ideal proc chance. Of course, maybe it's not going to be perfect, but you can always adjust it. And as you can see, if we take the fire tower, well, the damage and the proc and debuff time is damage and proc is going to be upgraded, but the lower stats like tick time and tick damage is not upgraded when we upgrade the fire tower. So we need to do something about that, and that's why we made the function virtual so that we can override it in each tower and make a function that upgrades the tower correct, because the normal tower function or the tower class is not going to know how to upgrade the fire tower. So we can go into the fire tower script and make an upgrade function and override it and set the tick time minus equal the next upgrade dot tick time. And it needs to be the one with non-capital like this. And then we simply have to do the same for our damage, tick damage. And that should be plus equal because we increase the damage and we reduce the tick time. The special damage. So we can save this. And we can do the same for the frost tower. Let's create a new function. And again, here we take the slowing factor. And we need to increase the slowing factor. And of course, we need to say plus equal instead of just setting it equal. So let's do that. And then we take the poison tower and do the same, create a new function, override that upgrade function. So this dot splash damage plus equal next upgrade that's special damage. And this dot tick time plus equal next upgrade that's tick time. Well, actually it's minus equal because it needs to be reduced, of course. And yeah, so then now we have the upgrade function for the poison tower as well. The storm tower, well, it doesn't really need anything new because it's everything is contained inside the normal tower function, so we can just leave it blank. So if we play the game now, see if we can take an ice tower, place it, and we can upgrade it by clicking the button here. And as you can see, the upgrade is applied. But the price of the tower is not upgraded. You can see it's $10 no matter what. And we want to see the actual upgrade price here. So we need to do something so we can see it. The price for selling the tower is updated when we click the tower, not right away. You can see I can upgrade it. It still says $1 here. So when I click away from the tower and click back on it, it updates. So we also want it to update every time we create an upgrade, of course. So let's also add that so we have some better UI. So if we go to the game manager and we open up the upgrade tooltip, then we'll see that we set the tooltip when we select the tower right there. We have a select tower, but we also need to do this at another point. So if we say that our select the tower dot next upgrade is null, well, then we would like to update the text, the upgrade text. So if we go to the top here, see, we have something called stat text, and we need to create a private text, and we want to call it upgrade text or upgrade price. We can also call that and write serialized field. And then down here, we write upgrade price dot text. Then we need to set it equal to the selected tower dot next upgrade dot price to string. And we also want to add a dollar sign after it. So we're just going to write that like this. So this will add something to the actual upgrade price text. And then underneath, we need to set it to empty. So when we don't have more upgrades, we simply just clear the price so that the user isn't confused. And you can see that there is nothing else to upgrade because we don't have a price on it. So if we run it now, let's see, we just need to take the game manager and see the upgrade price text. Well, we need to take the upgrade text and apply it here so that we can also have a reference to it. Then we click the tower, place it. And if I... You can see it didn't happen until I moused over, actually. So there's an error here. If I click there, it says $10. And when I mouse over the button, it actually updates. So we wanted to update right away when we click the actual tower. So let's see, where should we put this? We have a select function somewhere. Not select tower. I want the select function, which is inside our tower script. Let's see if we can find it. There we go, there, select, and here we need to add something. So we need to say game manager dot instance dot update upgrade tip, like so. So this will upgrade it right away when we select the tower. So let's try to play it now. Now I should have the right price right away when I place a tower and click it. So now it says $2 right there, not 10. And when I click, it updates 5, and then there's no value because there's no more upgrades, as you can see. But if you look at it besides it, if I click, if you saw next to it, there was actually a problem because there was a dollar sign next to the price for selling it. So we need to do that as well. So if we go to the function called upgrade tooltip, we need to update the actual price for selling it as well. So if we go to sell text dot text, and it needs to be equals the price, the selected tower dot price divided by 2. And I would also like to have a dollar sign after it. So I'm simply going to add it like this. There we go. And then we save. And then we can jump back to Unity. See, if we place a tower, click on it, and you can see that it has a dollar sign after it, but it didn't update until I moused over it, as you can see. So when I place the tower like this, selected, it says plus one, not $1. And when I mouse over it, like so, when I mouse over the upgrade button, then it updates. So we need to update it so it has the right text right away. And to do that, we go to the game manager script, find select tower. And then you can see the sell text here is just printed in without the dollar sign. So we can just add it like this by adding a dollar sign in the end here. And there we go. But you can see there was a difference. There was a change when I moused over the upgrade. There's a space between the value and the dollar sign. So basically I can go to the actual script. And in there, I can just make a space between the value and the dollar sign. Let's try to do that. So here we can just make a space. And if I make that space and save, then you'll see that it looks the same now. When I mouse over that thing, it's still the same. And you can see upgrade doesn't have a space. So I can also go in and make sure there's a space there if I want to. But it's up to you if you want the space or not. I can just go to the, what is it called? The game manager function. For upgrading the tooltip and make a space here. And if I save that and go back here, then you'll see that if I click here, then it has the same space. So now it looks more identical. So that's what I want to do in this video. Thank you very much for watching. Thanks for watching my video. Please remember that InScope Studios is a community-founded page, so please consider clicking the support link on the screen to see how you can support me and get something back in return.